friends, today I want to teach you to play a little game like this. It's called Spin It. Now, to find it, it's in your math packet that we sent home with you. It's page 8. So look for page 8. And you can gently pull it out just like I did and work with it. It's called Spin It. Now, it might help if you have some little counters of some sort, some of the ones we sent home, or anything that you can line up and build an array with. You could use cereal or whatever you have. But we're going to look at this together. I'm going to show you how to do it. It says, use your pencil tip to hold the loop of a paper clip to the center of the spinner. Flick the paper clip and see what number you land on. So I've got a paper clip here, my pencil. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick my pencil in there, and then it becomes a spinner. I can thump it like this to figure something out. And within whatever it lands on, like this time it landed on 16, I'm going to look for an array or a description of an array that equals 16. Okay, that's going to be a pretty big number, so I know not even to look at this, because I can tell that's not up to 16. Let's see. Let's see what this one equals. Let's see. This is 3, 3, 3, 3. So 3, 6, 9, 12. So that's a 12 one. That's not going to work. Let's check these hearts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. All right. That one equals 16. And it says color in the box. So we're going to just color in that whole box. Doesn't matter the color, just whatever color you want. And that one equals 16. And then I'm going to thump it again. And the goal is to get all of them in, colored in. Okay, now I found 9. 3 plus 3 plus 3. Well, let's see. I can't remember what that is. So I might use my counters here, and I might build a 3. Plus a 3, plus a 3. Let's see what that equals. Get them all in neat rows and columns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, yes, that equals 9. So then you can color in that block. Okay? And I'm not doing a very good, neat job coloring. I need to stay in the lines a little bit better. Okay, and now we'll spin again. I'll do one more with you. 20. Oh, wow, that's a big one. I think I will look. Let's look at this one. 4 rows of 5. So it's going to have 4 rows. Let me zoom out a little bit here. It's going to have 4 rows, and there's going to be 5 in each row. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I need to make it a little neater, don't I? So there's 2 rows of 5. Now let's see if we can get. So how many rows is that now? That's 3 rows. 1 row, 2 rows. 3 rows. Remember, they go across. Rows go across. And now this last one, let's see if I can get 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm seeing if 4 rows of 5 equals 20. So I've got 4 rows. See, 1 row, 2 rows, 3 rows, 4 rows. And each row has 5 in it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So let's count by fives and see if that equals the 20 that I spun. 5, 10, 15, 20. All right, it does equal 20. So I can color that one, that box too. So you're going to continue playing this until you get all of them colored. And you might eventually spin something that you don't have up here. So you just keep spinning until you get what you need. And then on the other side, you have to do a little bit of work here. there is a column for the description that tells you how many rows, and in each row, there's a column for the picture, and there's a column for the number sentence or the equation. Okay, so like the first one, they did it for you. They said 3 rows of 4, and then look, they drew you a picture of 3 rows of 4, and then they wrote the number sentence. 4 plus 4 plus 4, and that equals 12. So now let's look at this next one. They gave you one piece of it, but you have to figure out the other ones. Well, let's see. It's going to be 3, 3, 3. So I think I can do the number sentence first. So that's going to be a 3 plus a 3 plus a 3. And what does that equal? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's going to equal 9. And then to write a description, you can kind of use this one like a copycat, except change the numbers. So this one says 3 rows. So how many rows do we have? 3. So that's the same. 3 rows of, but this one doesn't, this one says 4. This one doesn't have 4 in each row. How many is in each row? 3. She would write 3 rows of 3. Okay? Can't wait to see your work.